From coaches taking their clothes off to protest the refereeing, to an athlete using a flower pot to jump a hurdle, check out today's Inappropriate Moments in Sports broadcast live. The last fights in Greco-Roman wrestling of the Rio Olympic Games ended in a striptease on the mat. No, you're not dreaming. During the small final of the category of 65 kilos, the spectators present in the spans of the Carioca Arena 2 attended an unusual scene. It all began when the Mongolian, Mandakanarin Gonzarig, had taken the lead over his Uzbek opponent, Ikhtiyor Nafruzov, leading 7-6. When the fight resumed, with only 30 seconds left on the clock, the Mongolian wrestler, proud of his performance, started to turn around his opponent, raising his arms in victory, but he didn't like it. Indeed, this wrestler fell down after the referees judged his behavior as a refusal to fight. They gave him a penalty, which allowed the Uzbek to come back to a 7-7 tie and win the bronze medal, all of which fueled the anger of the Mongolian clan. Outraged by the refereeing decision, a Gonzarig coach let his anger explode to the cheers of the audience. However, if he only took off his top and angrily threw his shoes, one of which landed in the hands of a member of the judges, another coach went even further. So much so that he took off his pants and ended up in his underwear in front of the judges' table. Of course, shortly thereafter, both coaches were led out of the sports arena by security. But that's not the worst of it. These striptease protests did not change the referees' decisions. Nevertheless, they gave the public and the internet users a memorable moment. In 2019, the French figure skating award ceremony turned into a comical event, to say the least. The reason? Well, the president of Grenoble-Alpes-Metropole, Christophe Ferrari, gave the gold medal to Mariah Bell, except that the latter had actually arrived at the third place of the podium. So after accepting the award and thanking the man warmly, Mariah Bell, all smiles, probably didn't suspect anything, until the American Alina Zagitova, who came second, informed her that the medal was to be given to Alina Kasternaya, the winner of the competition. Without further ado, Mariah Bell complied, but in front of such a mistake, the three champions couldn't help but burst out laughing. As for Christophe Ferrari, he finally gave the other two medals to the winners, and this time without making a mistake. Nevertheless, we can imagine that this moment of the sport has something to mark the spirits, especially since the protocol of such a ceremony is usually very strict. It is known that in the steeplechase, the athletes have to run 3,000 meters while facing the numerous changes of pace imposed by the crossing of five barriers every 400 meters, including a barrier with a river. However, one athlete had apparently found a way to make the competition less complex. It is the Papua New Guinean Sopai Yao. At the 2010 Commonwealth Games, he was running on the field, just like his other opponents. However, when he arrived at the water-filled pit, the athlete chose not to cross it by jumping the fence. Instead, he opted for a completely different solution. As he approached the obstacle, Sopai Yao spotted some flower pots just below the barrier. So, he simply used one of them as a support before crossing the barrier in a way as strange as comical. Thanks to his tactics, he didn't need to muster the energy to jump the barrier. On the contrary, it even allowed him to catch his breath. Not surprisingly, the man found himself disqualified from the competition. However, if Sopai Yao helped himself to a flower pot, it is mainly because he is not taller than 1.52 meters and he was at the end of his strength. But as you must have guessed, the rules of the game make no exception. During a 110-meter hurdle race qualifying for the London Olympic Games, a young Chinese man stood out not because he came in first, but because of his epic race. Indeed, this university student did not seem to understand the purpose of the game since he decided to run his own way, using his own rules. From the start, he realized that he couldn't get over the hurdles in the traditional way. And seeing his competitors going faster than him, the young Chinese man decided to try a new method, to run straight without bothering to jump the barriers. The supposed athlete then reversed all the hurdles and lived this race as a classic 100 meters. This obviously made him gain a few paces. However, this atypical runner got confused because he fell on the neighboring lane, thus disturbing another runner. Naturally, the sprinter continued the race in the next lane. We understand why this runner made a sensation on social networks. Unfortunately for him, his unorthodox method got him disqualified. At the 2016 Raw Unity Powerlifting Championships in Port St. Lucie, Florida, a woman attempted a deadlift from a large bar, but it ultimately resulted in an unusual video sequence, and it is not wrong. The candidate won of the candidates present during this event gave everything to win the competition, and maybe even a little too much. Indeed, the weightlifter gave so much effort that she vomited close to the members of the jury, a truly embarrassing situation. Nevertheless, this young woman, nicknamed Blonde Beauty Brie on Instagram, was rather proud of her performance, especially since she didn't give up despite the unexpected event. Moreover, she posted the same video sequence on her own social networks, and she even went so far as to reshare the memes that tried to make fun of the weightlifter. And it must be said that it did not work because she does not seem to be embarrassed by the situation. At least we hope that the jury will take more distance in the future if this same woman reappears. On Sunday, October 4th, 2020, in Lonato, Italy, the finals of the World Karting Championship were marked by an event as unlikely as it was surreal. In fact, on this occasion, the driver Luca Corberi became famous all over the world, despite himself. And we must admit that it is not without reason. The latter, forced to abandon the race following a collision with Paolo Ippolito, decided, in defiance of his safety and that of his fellow drivers, to throw his bumper on his opponent, a crazy move that has, without further delay, made the tour of all social networks. Especially since Luca Corberi did not stop there. At the end of the race, he got physical in the pits. Forced to be disqualified from the event, the young man then had to face heavy consequences as he was banned from all sporting competitions for 15 years by the International Tribunal of the International Automobile Federation, FIA. And although he has informed the public that he does not wish to participate in any sporting competition for the rest of his life after having apologized, Luca Corberi will undoubtedly remain forever in the annals of karting. In August 2016, an Olympic swimmer on the Spanish national team named Miguel Duran Navia had a nerve-wracking moment, to say the least. While standing on the block, patiently waiting for the start during the fourth heat of the 400-meter freestyle, the athlete unfortunately made a terrible mistake. Indeed, Miguel Duran Navia completely missed his start. And for good reason, the Spaniard dived into the Olympic pool well before all his opponents. This leads, according to the rules, to an immediate disqualification. It is thus the eyes filled with sobs that the young Spaniard left the pool, visibly still under the shock and destroyed by his false start. Following this, he simply left the competition to a standing ovation, his belongings in hand. However, things finally took an unexpected turn to the delight of the swimmer. Yes, while he was leaving the place, he was quickly caught by a referee who took into consideration that a noise coming from the stands could have misled Duran Navia, but also that, falling into the water, the athlete had made an effort to stay on the pole of the start line. Therefore, he was able to come back with an even bigger ovation for a second chance. This was undoubtedly a great relief for the young athlete. However, it would have done him no good as he finished in last place in the series. In 2004, the synchronized diving event in Athens, Greece was marked by an astonishing and hilarious event. As the divers were warming up for the competition, a Canadian named Ron Benjamin appeared out of nowhere on the springboard of the pool. He wanted to be noticed, and he did. The man who suddenly appeared on the board was dressed in a blue tutu and leggings. On his chest, he had thought of writing the web address of a casino, which he probably wanted to promote. It was a situation rarely seen during a competition. However, the spectators apparently enjoyed the presence of this intruder and even seemed to encourage him to jump. Ron, for his part, was enjoying the moment by bowing to the astonished public. Afterwards, a security guard tried to stop him, but the man wasn't about to give up that easily. He took his courage in both hands before diving into the pool. Unfortunately, Ron Benjamin soon regretted his actions as he received a 5-month jail sentence. "I never thought it would get this bad," he said. He also assured that he did not do it for the money, but only for the fame. Faced with such a turn of events, he appealed the sentence. This allowed him to regain his freedom. On the other hand, he had to pay a fine of 3,225 Canadian dollars or 2,000 euros. What to dissuade him in the future to be clever? At the 2018 Olympic Games, the North Korean Jong Kwang-bom did not shine in the best way on the heats of the 500 meters of the short track speed skating. Far from there. The young man, 17 years old, seemed to know little about this sport when he arrived in Pyeongchang. The proof with his quite amusing performance. At the announcement of the departure, the young man threw himself in the competition when he fell heavily a first time. But not wanting to fall alone, he tried to catch the Japanese competitor on his right, Kito Watanabe, in a way that seems quite voluntary, as we can see in the images captured live by the cameras. Nevertheless, this attempt was a total failure since his opponent had not fallen. At that moment, the referees decided to declare the incident as a false start and give, at the same time, a second chance to Jong Kwang-bom. But the North Korean skater did even worse on the second attempt. Indeed, the young man had not only fallen again miserably, but he had also stretched his two legs to make the same opponent fall. This North Korean had apparently quite a grudge against the Japanese. That's why he was disqualified. He was definitely stuck in speed skating without being asked. In August 2012, during the Olympic Games, a women's water polo match between the United States and Spain did not go unnoticed. While NBC was broadcasting the match on its airwaves, an underwater incident seemed to shock all viewers. Why? Well, a fight broke out, for mysterious reasons, between two competitors, the American Cami Craig and the Spanish Matilde Ortiz, which is relatively common, except that things went a bit further. Indeed, the American ended up tearing the shirt of her competitor and a nipple appeared on the screen, a moment probably very embarrassing for the young Spanish, although it was very brief. And as expected, this incident was enough to trigger a real controversy. Then followed a flood of comments on social networks, especially to criticize the American channel. Now it's your turn to tell us in the comments which of these moments is, in your opinion, the most inappropriate. And if you like this video, don't forget to give us a like, to subscribe to the channel, and activate the bell to receive all the notifications and not miss anything of our next videos.